Coach Robinson, second place, half a point to Penn State, going into the final day of the NCAA tournament. Coach, what changed about the semifinals from Big Ten to here? Dylan Ness really turned it on. He didn't have the Big Ten tournament. He's in the finals now.
I think that what they're doing is they're wrestling with passion. They're wrestling with excitement. We went back. I think we lost our focus a little bit at the Big Ten and Southern Scuffle. And there's some things we did in practice and match preparation, I think, that's made a little bit of difference. And then we're doing all the things that we say every time. I pretty much tell them the same thing every time, is that what you have to do. And then we try and keep them focused on just one match at a time, and we'll get there that way.
The break for when you held Tony Nelson out, he had a hand injury, he didn't wrestle the national duels, didn't really do much at the national duels. Hold him out, did that work out for you guys, do you believe?
We didn't hold him out because of his hand. We didn't hold him out. I mean, that's a big misnomer. That's a thing that people say, that we're holding him out, sitting him. Okay, he pulled his finger really super, super bad. All right? He had a really bad injury. If we needed him, we would have wrestled him. But we didn't want to aggravate the injury at all. So we weren't sitting him out to sit him out for any other reason. And we did some different things with Tony's training in about the last 5 weeks, and he's really super responded to it.
How'd you feel about a semifinal match?
I thought he wrestled a great one. I got all the respect for Telford. I mean, they wrestled hard. He comes to win, you know, and we knew that it was going to be a little bit different. We thought that they were going to try and change something up, and that's exactly what they did, and it changed the whole complexity of the match.
And the finals tomorrow?
Finals tomorrow. Is that, got to go back, think about what we got to do, and get ready for that.
What does a guy like Schiller got to do? What's a guy like Silverberg got to do? What are those guys got to do for you tomorrow, for you guys to walk out with the gold trophy and not the silver?
We got to score as many points as we can, right? We got to win as many matches as we can. If we get bonus points, we got to get bonus points. And that's pretty much the sum of it. And that's what it's going to come down to. We're going to have a pretty good idea behind the finals what's going to be needed.
Look at the performance. You had some disappointing performances by the Dardanes brothers. Now, those guys are tougher than nails. I think they epitomize what Minnesota wrestling's about. What do you say to guys like that to get them back up for next year?
Well, I mean, I think that they'll get themselves up for next year. But I talked to Nick a little bit on the way over here, some things that he needs and some adjustments, and I think that's what it is. And I think that those guys are super dedicated, and they'll come back and they'll think about it and they'll work on it, and they'll spend these next 11 months, 12 months getting ready, because it stinks, okay? It hurts. It has to hurt. If it doesn't hurt, you're not going to change anything, you know. Billie Jean King, a lady, you know, tennis player, she said something about, you know, winning. She said, the reason I like to win is because it hurts too much to lose. Okay, they're hurting right now, but they'll come back. They're warriors. They'll come back. They'll fight, and they'll make some adjustments, and it'll put them in a completely different place a year from now.
Silverberg, All-Americaning, that's huge. I've been saying all year, Minnesota's only going to do as good as Danny Silverberg does. Obviously, a guy like that, he's doing a great job being a leader for you. What's it mean to you for a guy like that to come back an All-American for you?
Well, I think it's a great thing for Danny and the team, because I think that what it does is it sums up what it's about. Okay, it's a team thing. We told him beforehand, and he knows that he had to step up. We needed him, and those points are big right now. They're making all the difference in the world. You know, these guys are a team. They pull together, and it's made a big difference.
Thorne has absolute gifted athlete in the round of 12, a two-time All-American, Ryan Mangle. What do you say to him in that match?
Well, I mean, the same thing. It's like, focus on what you're doing, right? Get out there and make them wrestle your match, okay? You got to inflict your will upon them, right? And in order to do that, you have to be very super intense and focused, right? Concentration is, the definition of concentration is, wherever you are, be there. They got to be there for 7 minutes. That's the most important thing.
With what you have in play, what Oklahoma State has in play, and what Penn State has in play, do you see your guys taking the gold trophy tomorrow?
We're going to come here, and we're going to win as many matches as we can. We're going to wrestle unbelievably hard. We're going to take care of what we can take care of tomorrow. And I know my guys will do that, right? They're going to wrestle with intensity. They're going to wrestle with focus. They're going to be hard, and they know what's at stake, right? And they're going to go out there, and they're going to do what Minnesota does. They're going to wrestle hard.
Has Ness ever beaten Deringer?
They only wrestled once, I think.
And Deringer won.
Deringer won.
But you think that's to your advantage?
I think that this is the NCAA national finals. All kinds of things happen here. I got all the confidence in the world in Dylan.
Does he give you some heart flutters every now and again?
Dylan's Dylan. I mean, you can't coach it. You just got to make sure he's in the right place mentally, okay? And he'll be excited. He's got a chance to be an NCAA champion tomorrow. He got there 2 years ago. He didn't get there last year, so he's hungry for it. He'll be ready.
All right, Coach, you got anything else for me?
Got nothing.
Thanks for the time. Good. Oh, if Minnesota leaves with a gold trophy tomorrow, will Jay Robinson be done coaching?
Oh, jeez.
I'm not going to stop. I'm going to keep asking.
I don't know. I have no idea when I'm going to be done. Okay, the same thing you ask. As long as I'm enjoying what I'm doing, I'm going to keep doing it.
All right, Coach, thanks for the time. Good luck tomorrow.
You bet.